Good morning. Buenos dias. Embajadores y amigos diplomáticos de América Latina. Bienvenidos a la tierra de Tamils. Welcome to the land of Tamils, Tamiluna. Now, you would have found many things different here than what is there in Delhi. One of the differences is history. Yeah, as Ambassador Cardenas was mentioning, the history of Delhi is a history of foreign invasions, subjugation, and domination. But here in Tamil Nadu, in the 9th, 10th, 11th centuries, we had a Chola dynasty which went outside of India to conquer other countries, Sri Lanka, parts of Indonesia, parts of Malaysia, parts of Cambodia. Now, this is the first and the only instance in Indian history where Indians had gone abroad to conquer. Now, it is continuing now in the 21st century too. We have a famous actor called Rajnikanth. He went and conquered Machu Picchu in Peru. He did a dance with Aishwarya Roy on top of Machu Picchu. He is the first Indian actor to conquer Machu Picchu. I was told that since Machu Picchu is a sacred place, they don't give permission. In fact, they denied permission to James Bond film, Quantum of Solace. But then the Tamils have a talent to achieve that. And there have been global conquests of Tamils. The latest you might have heard of Sundar Pichai, who has conquered Google to become the CEO. And we have a lady from Tamil Nadu called Indra Nui, who conquered Pepsi Cola. And in business too, we have a mid-sized pharmaceutical company called Coupling Point, who do about 40 million dollars of exports of pharmaceuticals. Now, 90% of their exports go to Latin America, and mainly to Central America and Guatemala. We have a small company in Chennai, a traditional company called Eagle Press Group, based to publish Eagle Diaries. Now, this company does the lottery solutions for Chile, for Colombia, for Mexico, and some other countries. They have a motorcycle company called TVS. They export $100 million of motorcycles to Latin America. Now my Latin American friends would say that you guys are conquering Latin America, what about us? Yes, you too. The owner of this pharmaceutical company, Coupling Point, he sent his son, Ashok Parthiban, to Guatemala City to promote exports. And he was promptly caught, conquered, and married by a Guatemalan girl. And he settled over. From Chennai, two young boys, one called Rakesh Vaidyanathan and another one called Arvind Krishnan, they had gone to Brazil. And they were promptly caught and married by the two Brazilian garotas. And they are settled over there promoting business between India and Brazil. There's a boy from Coimbatore called Mohan. He had gone to Colombia with a software company. Yeah? He also became a victim of the charm of Colombia. He's married to a Colombian and he started a local company called Soco Solutions, which is doing extremely well. But seriously, you have conquered India in business too. There is, if you go in the IT corridor of Chennai to a place called Sirusen, there is building of TCS, Tata Consultancy Services. This is a unique building in India and one of the unique buildings in the world. It is one of the largest office complexes in the world, where there are 28,000 people work there in one place. And it's got a very beautiful and unique design with the state of art technology. And this was designed by a Uruguayan architect called Carlos Ott. So I wrote a blog called Uruguayan Touch to Indian Tech. We have a company from Peru called Ate, A-J-E. You know, when Pepsi and Coke entered India, they killed and finished the local cola companies. Our companies either sold themselves or surrendered. But here comes this Peruvian company called Ate. They, A-J-E, Ate. They are competing with these companies in the cola market in India with a brand called Big Cola. And they have put up a plant in Maharashtra. And they are selling their Big Cola in Indonesia and Vietnam and Thailand, in addition to other 20 countries around the world. And in India, films have a lot of influence, we have a lot of cinema halls. There is a Mexican company called Cinepolis. Now, this company is investing $150 million in setting up multiplexes in second and third tier cities around India. So don't underestimate Latin American business and success in India. Many of you would think that Latin America is too far, the shipping is infrequent, the cost of freight is high, and the trade with Latin America is marginal. Some of you might think that Europe is more important than Latin America, or neighboring countries, we do more trade, and we do more trade with close trading partners than with Latin America. Let me shock and surprise you with the latest statistics from the Ministry of Commerce from 2014-15, April 2014 to March 2015. Now, we did a trade of $12.2 billion with Venezuela and $11.4 billion with Brazil. Now, this is more than our trade with Sri Lanka and Bangladesh, close neighbors, Thailand and Vietnam, France and Netherlands. We did a trade with Mexico of $6.25 billion. Now, this is more than our trade with Spain and Italy, with Canada, with Egypt and Israel and Nepal. We did a trade of $3.6 billion with Colombia last year, $3.6 billion with Chile, $3.25 billion with Colombia, and $2.5 billion with Argentina. This is much more than about 15 European countries. We imported last year more crude oil from Venezuela, $12 billion, than from close sources, UAE and Kuwait. Our exports to Brazil last year was $6 billion. Now, this is more than India's exports to Japan, Korea, Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, Vietnam, France, Spain, Italy, South Africa, Egypt, and Turkey, which you all think that they are close trading partners. Our exports to Mexico, $2.8 billion, is more than our exports to Canada, Australia, and Russia. And our exports to Guatemala, $229 million. To Trinidad, $165 million. This is more than our exports to Cambodia and to Maldives. India is becoming, Chennai is becoming a hub of automobile exports. Last year, we exported $1.8 billion of vehicles to Latin America, which is 23% of our total exports. Today, the largest market for Indian cars is Mexico. Last year, we exported $780 million. And Colombia alone, we exported motorcycles worth $270 million. Well, the statistics speaks for themselves. And it is a large market. It's a market of 580 million people, $6.2 trillion, with a trade of $2 trillion. And the middle class is growing and the consumption is growing. The economies are becoming more stable and prosperous, and the macroeconomic fundamentals are becoming healthier and stronger. Of course, you'll say that this year the average growth rate is only 0.5%, but this is a cyclical downturn.